after walking my dog, singing my song, strolling along. It's just me and my dog, catching some sun. We can't go wrong. And I don't care about your hate and your doubt, and I don't care what the politicians spout. If you need a companion, why just go out by the pound and find yourself a hound and make that dog get proud, 'cause that's what it's all about.
Hello and welcome to Rescue Roundtable. I'm Mary Catalano. Today we have a very special guest. He's my only guest, but he's going to take up all the time and it's very worthwhile. Bill Dyer, one of the founding members of In Defense of Animals. Bill, hello.
Hello, Mary.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming. Yeah. This is going to be a little bit different than the other shows that we've done so far. We were talking mainly about companion animals.
Right.
There was just so many issues.
I know.
It just doesn't
Well, you can
end.
Do
it.
It
never
do.
Ends. We do everything. But your specialty in defense of animals has gone into all sorts of different areas.
Yes.
And I'd like to just have you explain to me how the organization was started. And or were you one of the founding members?
Well, actually,
just tell us all about it.
Yeah, I wasn't a founding member, actually. I've been with IDA for about 8 years now, but it was founded by Dr. Elliot Katz and out of San Francisco, and he's a very humane person. And we tackle every issue. I mean, there's so much animal abuse and exploitation in this world, and it's just, I really don't even have to search for an issue because my phone will ring and I'll have an issue.
Yes.
Like yesterday, it was squirrels on Huntington Beach that they're killing, or coyotes in Oceanside that they want to kill. I mean, every day, it's like, you know, let's not look for an humane alternative. Let's just kill them, and it's mainly like through government agencies and fish and game and so forth. Or a lot of the calls I get now too are about overpopulation of rabbits in gated communities, and because they're eating their pretty flowers
oh
and
dear.
Stuff like that,
God
and
forbid.
So they want them killed. They want the rabbits killed, and there are humane alternatives to every situation, but people are too lazy, or they think that it's expedient to kill them. But it's been proven over and over again that killing is not the solution, because for example, rabbits or squirrels or whatever wildlife, they'll always be there.
Mm-hmm.
Killing does not solve the problem. Okay. So anyway, as I say, IDA is involved with a lot of groups. I mean, a lot of issues, including companion animals, that this program is mainly about. And I love the intro, the new intro that's on the pictures
Bouncing,
there.
Yeah.
That's very nice. And I try and do what I can. I'm part of a coalition here in Los Angeles. We came up with the new legislation regarding dog licensing and breeder's permit. It's like the model for the United States. $100 now for a breeding permit, $100 for a dog license if your dog is not altered. And that's something, that legislation we worked on with actors and others, the Amanda Foundation, some other groups. And it's really the best legislation in the country. And it's a model for other cities. And all outside cats must be fixed, that sort of thing.
And that's legislation now?
Well, sure. It's been part of the law.
All outside cats must be fixed?
Yes,
I didn't realize
that's
that.
Part of it.
Oh, my
that's
God,
part
that's fantastic.
Of it. And if you breed a dog or a cat, it's not just limited to dogs, you have to have a $100 breeder's permit. You have to. And so we worked on that. This is a coalition that I belong to called CEPO, which means the Coalition to End Pet Overpopulation.
Mm-hmm.
So we deal in that issue.
Mm-hmm.
But there are a host of other issues. As I say, they come up all the time. And we try and join with other groups. Like recently, I attended a demonstration at Kentucky Fried Chicken that PETA put on.
Right.
And so we do that. And then every year, we sponsor them through the march of the anti-fur march through Beverly Hills,
yes.
Which is a traditional affair. We do, it's the day after Thanksgiving, the biggest shopping day of the year.
Mm-hmm.
We march through Beverly Hills to go buy all the fur stores and do that. So, I mean, but there's a lot of issues. Right now, up north, the main office is in Mill Valley, California,
yes.
And they've played a big role now in getting two elephants out of the San Francisco Zoo, which are going to go to Pat Derby's place up in Galt called Paws, Performing Animal Welfare
retirement.
Society. Yeah, they're
is
going to
a
sanctuary. And they have a lot of land to go on. And recently, it's an amazing thing, the Detroit Zoo is giving up two elephants. And they're going to the elephant sanctuary in Tennessee. This is like unheard of, where two zoos have given up animals to go to sanctuaries. It's an amazing thing, and I hope it's the beginning. Because you see, the zoos, the exhibits are not large enough. These animals are normally in the wild walk 30 miles a day.
Right.
And a lot of them are standing on concrete, which is very bad for their joints and their feet, and they get harmed that way. And the exhibits are just simply too small. And then this man, this wonderful zoo director at the Detroit Zoo, just said, "I'm doing this for the welfare of the animals." If they go to Tennessee, the elephant sanctuary in Tennessee, they're going to have 2,300 miles.
Oh, that's wonderful.
2,300 acres to be on instead of what? 10 by 12 or whatever it is. It's very small, And so maybe that's the beginning. I hope so. But anyway, as I say, issues. We have national issues we were involved with. An issue here in the state recently was foie gras. There's only one company in California that manufactures foie gras. They put the pipes down the geese.
Explain it. I don't think people know.
Well, they fatten their liver. That's what it is. And they feed them this grain through a tube in their mouth. They force feed it, these animals, and they slaughter them and they sell the liver. And makes into this delicacy, so-called foie gras. Well, that's over, because the bill passed. The only to outlaw it, because it's outlawed in maybe 7-8 countries in Europe and so forth. The unfortunate thing about the bill is it doesn't take effect till 7 years from now.
Oh, no.
To give the foie gras manufacturer this business chance to retool his business.
So, oh my God.
I tell you what I have learned with animal rights, and that's what I call it. I call it animal rights, is that we win by baby steps. Most of the time, it seems like we're not winning, but we are. It's very gradual, it's very slow, but there's indications. For example, the elephant thing. The foie gras thing, 7 years from now, but okay. Because the forces against us, I don't care what issue you talk about. For example, vivisection. We've not made inroads to even stop some of the redundant.
Tell people
literature.
What it is. Some people don't even know what that is.
Well, in the dictionary, it'll say the cutting up of live animals. That's what it'll tell you. It's animal experimentation on living animals. It's not dissection, which is dead animals,
right?
But live animals. And it goes on everywhere.
And what was the purpose?
Well, for research. They'll tell you, my dear, that they will be finding the cure for cancer.
Well, it's all
and
about
us. And the cure for A. We're going to torture. You see, here's what knocks me out about vivisection is this: they research and torture and abuse animals because they're so much like us, and we'll find cures for us.
Isn't
okay?
that great?
But it's okay to torture them because they're not like us. You see, so they got it both ways. And believe me, it's all about money. It's not about anything else. For every dollar that UCLA gets for one of their research grants, the government, the National Institutes of Health, gives them 50 cents in allied funding for parking lots, for buildings, for this and that. So that's you see UCLA, all those beautiful new medical buildings. That was bought on the dead animals, and so I brought all that up to illustrate to you that the forces against us are very great, and that's why it's difficult to make inroads. I mean, with the drug companies and the people, the lobbyists that control, and look at agriculture. Why do you think we have you know about factory farming? How terrible food animals, so-called food animals, are treated. The food animals don't have one pleasant day in their life, not from when they're born to when they're slaughtered. It's horrible. The factory.
Now, Bill, I really don't think people know about this. So.
Factory farming. Well, it's a food animal.
I'm just saying.
Pigs, cows,
think
chickens, and these battery cages are all stuffed in these
the
cages together.
The general public doesn't know unless they start reading or they take an interest in it. And that's why we're here. We want people to know what's going on.
Well, I wish everybody was a vegan, but I'm practical. I know that they're not, okay? But at least if we could make their lives a little pleasant before we kill them, if they could just have one day where their beaks aren't cut or they're not, you know, put in all in these cages like veal crates, and I mean all of the horrible way that we treat them, but and it's all, and there we go again, it's all about money. You think you can change some of those laws? And you are, and talk about the puppy mills in the Midwest, churning out all these dogs that end up in pet stores here. You know, that's about money too. It's all about money.
Well, it almost always is.
All of them. Yeah. I'm talking too much. I'm sorry.
No. The puppy mills. Explain the puppy mills. People don't know about the puppy mills. People go to the Beverly Center, for example, mm-hmm. and they buy a dog, and mm-hmm. they think it's a really wonderful investment.
That's one of our big campaigns within Defense of Animals. What we're working at, and it's been successful in certain cities like West Hollywood and Berkeley and San Francisco and the state of Rhode Island and many other cities across the country. We're having the animal law where it refers in city codes to the owner of an animal. We want the word owner changed to guardian,
uh-huh.
or owner slash guardian, okay, to get out of this thing that we own animals, okay, like we used to own other people. We used to, you know, men owned their wives. Well, it's the same thing. We don't own animals. We own television sets, okay? But we don't own another living being.
We don't own cats. That's
no, they own whatever. but part of that campaign is to adopt and not to buy or sell.
Of course, because you're making more animals, it causes the pet stores.
Yeah, and mainly the animals. The so-called purebred animals in these pet stores. They've been the mother, their
bread
ancestors,
and bread,
bread and bread. Bread. So you're not getting a healthy animal.
Oh no, I know.
You'd be better going to a pound and getting a mixed breed animal that is much more healthy. But beside the point, the 25% of the animals in our shelter are purebred anyway. You see.
Yeah.
So it's better we ask people, because you're saving an animal's life. That's what you want to do. Let me just, I know we have a limited time. I wanted to tell you more about what I'm doing here locally.
Tell me about the buffaloes.
Yeah, okay.
We have some film on it. We want
right.
to make sure that we get that
This has to do with Catalina Island.
Uh-huh.
And it started really in 1999 when we learned that they were shooting a lot of goats on the island because they're non-native and they were overpopulating and harming the native vegetation there. So we stepped in and said, look, instead of shooting them, hello, could we relocate them?
Mm-hmm.
And they agreed and they worked with us on it.
Mm-hmm.
And I personally raised the money to do it, and we found a sanctuary up north, and we took off 123 goats in 1999. And there's just like four left, okay? I hope they just leave the house alone.
In Catalina.
Mm-hmm. Now, the same situation developed last year with buffalo.
How did buffalo get there?
The buffalo were brought over like in 1914 for the making of a silent film starring Richard Dix, a silent cowboy star called The Vanishing American. There were 14 brought over, and then through the years they multiplied. And of course, over the years, they have been sent to slaughter. They've been, you know, brought over and gone to the slaughterhouse. And
From Catalina.
Okay. They'd bring them over on the barge and da da da. So we stepped in and said, all right, here was a serious problem. And so we were able to, we worked with them and we raised the money again. And we were able to get them off the island, 105 in November, which you're going to see a little tape of it, and to a sanctuary in South Dakota. And what's wonderful, about 200 remain there right now on the island.
Mm-hmm.
They've accepted the whole concept of doing a contraceptive program for those that remain, so we don't have to go through this again. They don't overpopulate. It's not sterilization, it's contraception.
Mm-hmm.
And they dart the females, like those that they don't want to conceive, mm-hmm. once a year, so they don't have babies. So, and they'll keep, like, because it's sort of a tourist attraction.
It lasts
there
the whole year.
Yes, 1 year, then you have to do it again.
Great.
But you can identify which ones you're doing or not doing. And the buffalo are a tourist attraction on the island.
Mm-hmm.
And we're working with the Catalina Island Conservancy, which controls 98% of Catalina. And they've sort of really changed their policies now, and they really want to make it sort of a non-kill island. And I think this contraceptive program will really benefit many other situations around the world.
Absolutely.
That has an overabundance of whatever animal. This thing called PZP, which is the dart, the contraceptive dart, can be used on many different kinds of animals. So you don't have to kill them. Hello, people.
Yes.
Can we just stop killing? You see, you don't know me very well, but let me tell you, I'm against euthanasia in shelters. I'm against it. I always felt that where that concept ever started.
Well, how could they possibly use that word?
Well, I know it's a lie anyway.
That's absolutely preposterous.
That's right. I'm saying I'm against the killing of shelter animals. I feel if euthanasia, so-called euthanasia, had never been conceived of, they would have had to deal with the problem in a very real way. You got a million cats and dogs running in the street. What are you going to do? Deal with it then. But we're so used to it. It's so expedient, you know. And I know I get a lot of arguments about that even with my animal rights friends, but I'm against euthanasia. On record, I'm going on record today, ladies and gentlemen.
I agree with you 100%, Bill.
This tape that we have, it's part of a documentary I put together on. It's called Going Home, and it's just part of a 30-minute documentary.
Okay, great. Let's see that. Thank you.
Buffalo can roam. Many of the famous island buffalo are being moved to a sanctuary in South Dakota. Eyewitness News reporter Giovanna Latta explains why, live from Wilmington. Giovanna?
Ellen, more than 100 buffalo are inside these two semi-trucks here behind me. They are just now coming off a barge. Now, moments from now, they'll be driven 1,700 miles to South Dakota, where the buffalo, as you said, will be able to roam freely for the rest of their lives. Now, this is a huge rescue operation. The bison are from Catalina Island, and getting them here was quite an undertaking. These are pictures from Air 7 as the buffalo were being transported on the barge from the island to Wilmington, where we are now. Now, here's a little history for you. The first buffalo were introduced to Catalina Island back in the 1920s for the filming of a movie. Over the years, the buffalo became a tourist attraction there, but the population has outgrown the size of the island. Now, rather than selling the buffalo at an auction where they may have been destroyed, the folks from In Defense of Animals raised enough money and support to move them to South Dakota.
Well, saving their lives. And 200 remain on the island, and the Conservancy, we've been working with the Catalina Island Conservancy on this. They've been very cooperative. And those that remain on the island, they're going to have a managed colony, and they're talking about contraception so they don't multiply, so we don't have to go through this again. So that's generations of animals yet unborn who have been saved by this effort, and they're going home.
Now, if all goes well, the buffalo here will arrive in South Dakota by Thursday morning. Live in Wilmington, I'm Giovanna Latta, ABC 7 Eyewitness News.
Wa ya ki yelo hai Today we're very honored that these buffalo from Catalina, Ireland, west of California, they're coming in today, and they just come into Cheyenne River Reservation, our reservation here. Today we're very honored that they come back to our people. Our people were known as Pte Oyate, the buffalo people, and to us it brings great peace and harmony. We prayed that the spirit of the buffalo would return to the people, the spirit of the horses would return to the people. We're the only species that is destroying Mother Earth last 100 years. The spirit of the buffalo and the prophecy about the white buffalo calf being born, these are prophecies that we need to fulfill, and that spiritual connection to Mother Earth, the environment, and the Creator. We ask the Creator to help us. We still have to bring that the respect and honor and peace and harmony back to Mother Earth.
We call it Going Home. It's a 30-minute documentary.
We did. Where can we see it? We want to see it.
Well, you can't.
Oh, don't no, you hurt me. No, Bill,
you, yeah, no, you
you're
can't.
Hurting me now.
What are they doing? I think you can get it through IDA in Mill Valley. They have it up there.
In defense of animals.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You mean you can purchase it?
It's not a purchase, really. It's a gift, really. We're not selling them.
It's from.
You know, it's just a gift. You know, if you would like one, we'll give you one.
Wow. Yeah. I'd like one.
Yeah. All right. I got one. I can bring.
I'd love to.
Yeah.
The Native Americans treated everything. Everything with such honor.
Exactly. Respect.
What most infuriates me is the way that humans think they have a right to destroy other species.
Uh-huh. Right.
And that it's perfectly acceptable.
I know.
And they move into the neighborhood where the mountain lion is and then worry about the mountain lion eating their children.
That's right. That's right.
It's just appalling.
I know.
It's a disgrace.
I know. I can't bear it either.
I mean, these animals are perfection, and
we have to learn to coexist. I mean, a lot of people, I live in the Venice Canals, and we have a lot of ducks there, and they, you know, they go to the bathroom a lot, okay? Mm-hmm. But we learn to live with that. We love the ducks and the other animals that are there. You've got to learn to coexist with them, you know? And it's pleasure. It's a pleasure, you know? It's beautiful, you know? And I don't know. A lot of these gated communities with the rabbits and stuff, they want them dead. They just want them out of there. I don't understand that kind of thinking. I just don't, you know. I was talking to you before that I wish that we could have our own Fahrenheit 9/11 that would be about animals. Unfortunately, it's hard to get anything really important on television now because it tends to be graphic and people, it really upsets people. You can't get anything really important on television because it's graphic and it bothers people a lot, you know. And yet we can show pictures of men dying in war and all that. We can show that. But when it comes to animals, you see, people are very sensitive to that. Isn't that interesting? You know?
We have to go, Bill.
We do? Okay.
I really appreciate you coming here today.
Well,
it was so interesting.
Well,
and I want
good.
You to come back and we'll do like 12 more hours.
Okay. Well, the subject is endless.
It is. You know? It is endless and it's exhausting. It just,
it's too
much. So much to cover. In Defense of Animals is the organization. This is Bill Dyer. I'm Mary Catalano. Thank you for joining us today. In Defense of Animals is the magazine.
Yeah, you can have that. I guess. I'll get you that tape. Oh, well, in fact, you can take this one.
Okay.
I brought him. You can have it. I'm going home.
Right.
Be careful. Don't air it without telling me. I just use any music.
Oh, I know. Willing this song is not.
Yeah, I didn't clear any of it. And I said, Lord, I'm happy because I'm just walking my dog.